Yo, 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 Dr. Yo from ECA Wellness. Today, I'm going to talk to you about VO2 Max and anaerobic threshold. There's a lot of explanations out there and a lot of complex graphs, which can seem a bit overwhelming, but I'm going to keep it simple and I'm going to use your car as an example to explain things. But before I get started, let's roll the intro. Say you were planning a road trip, and you got to choose between driving a Ferrari or a Subaru. Which one would you choose? I bet most would choose the Ferrari. It's got the bigger and stronger engine, the smoother handling, and quite frankly, it's sexier. But what if I told you the Ferrari had poor gas mileage, and would need multiple stops along the way to gas up? So your 2-hour trip would turn into a 6-hour trip. Would you now reconsider choosing the Subaru? In my opinion, the best of both worlds is having a fuel-efficient Ferrari. So just like your car uses gas, your body uses oxygen to power itself up. The bigger the body's engine, also known as the cardiorespiratory system, the more oxygen it can pump and deliver out. Your VO2 max looks at the amount of blood your heart pumps out per heartbeat, and the amount of oxygen that goes into and out of your muscles. Simply put, the bigger your VO2 max, the bigger your engine. But this doesn't paint the entire picture, and this is where the concept of anaerobic threshold comes in. If you have ever felt the burn or felt nauseous after an intense workout, it is due to something called lactic acid. During these intense workouts, your body breaks down glucose into an energy molecule called ATP and another molecule called pyruvate. When your breathing gets heavy and labored during intense workout, the amount of oxygen present decreases, and this causes pyruvate to convert into lactic acid. Anaerobic threshold is the point where your muscles can no longer clear out the lactic acid efficiently, and it starts to spill out into your blood. So if your engine is not efficient enough in utilizing the oxygen, the lactic acid that builds up will cause you to fatigue and get tired quickly. And this is despite having a big engine. So my point is, while a bigger and powerful engine is desired, you also want to make sure it is fuel efficient so you get to your destination on time. When we test for VO2 max, we're determining how big your engine is. And when we test for anaerobic threshold, we're looking at your engine's fuel efficiency. Since fitness training and exercise are proven ways of improving both your VO2 max and your anaerobic threshold, now you know the next time you're at the gym or going out for a run, you're not only improving your engine, but also your sexiness. If you have any questions related to this topic, send me a message in the comments section below or on Instagram at ECA Wellness. Thanks so much for watching. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Ciao.